Jesus Christ is the King of Kings and Jesus Christ is the Lord of Lords. Pray Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord. And for the Rock Intercessor Ministries, I'm here today to preach to you the word of Jesus Christ, hoping that some of you will give your heart to Jesus Christ today. Today's message is Christian family. Christian family, let me say from up front, any family without Christ, that family is in crisis. Now in the book of Genesis chapter 3 verse 20, and Adam called his wife name Eve because she was the mother of all living. I want you today to think with me about the Christian family, and I want you also to see the fellow of the first family as recorded in the Bible. I'm thinking about the first family that God created, Adam and Eve and their children. You know, the Lord Jesus Christ loves Christian home. The Lord Jesus Christ built the first home in that Garden of Eden. The Lord Jesus Christ is now away building a heavenly home. The Lord Jesus Christ built the church home. And he said, I will build my church. And he wants to build your home. Wherever you live, with your husband, with your wife, with your children, the Lord Jesus Christ is intended to build your home and to make you to be the dearest place on earth and the nearest place to heaven. As a matter of fact, home is the only paradise that we have left. Everything else, as far as paradise is concerned, we don't have. When God made Adam and Eve, he put them in the paradise. You know what they did? They sinned against the Holy God, and God threw them out from that paradise. But at least they threw their home, and they threw their home with them. And so home is a very real sense, a part of paradise here on earth. And Jesus Christ is the greatest home builder. And ladies and gentlemen, you can definitely be sure of this and believe it. Devil is the greatest home destroyer. All you need to do is just open your eyes and see what is happening right now in the society. And you will see what the devil is doing, his dirty work, his devilish work, his deeds. He's doing his best to destroy and to ruin our homes and to rob us from the blessings of having a Christian home today in the society. You see, the devil is very clever because the devil knows that the Christian home is the blossom of which the heaven fruit is. And also, the devil is going to try to ruin the blossom so that there will not be fruit left. So the devil knows that if you ruin our homes, you will certainly ruin our lives. And the devil knows that. So be sure of this, friends. Way back in the Garden of Eden, the devil was so clever. He understood that he could cause humanity by destroying the first home. Now listen, I want you to see in Genesis chapter 3, God tells the greatest tragedy and has ever happened in the human race. In 51 words, Genesis chapter 3 verse 6. So when the woman, this is the first mother, when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that's the first point, that it was pleasant to the eyes, that's the second point, and the tree desirable to make one wise, and that's the third point. She took of the fruit and ate it, and not only that, my dear friend, listen, she also gave to the husband with her and he ate. So you see, devil knows how to share sin. What a tragedy. In just these 51 words, we see the secret and the failure of the first family being revealed. The first thing I want you to see, here is a mother with her own set of values. And this is something that is wrong here today with some mothers in UK. They have lost the sense of values and they have set a wrong set of values for themselves and their family. And I want you to see that the three things that were so important to Eve, and God mentioned them. Number one, she saw that the tree was good for food. Number two, it was pleasant to the eyes. Number three, a tree desired to make one wise. So you see, those are the three things that was more important to Eve in her life. First, something to eat. Second, pretty to look after. Third, something to stimulate her mind. And today, there's a lot of silly mothers in UK today who are going after these three things. And this is why I'm preaching this message today concerning Christian family, a Christian home. So if you think about it, my dear friend, if you don't have Christ in your home, let me say this, your home has been ruined by the devil, by the chance and by the practice and by the way devil is being perverted this society that we are living today. So the only thing that God left with us is home. Our family is important, my dear friend. But there's nothing wrong with food or feeding your body, but there's something wrong. If you are desiring food for your bodies, just Christ said, listen to this, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that comes from the mouth of God. So you see, also the Bible says, all things are lawful for me, but not all things are helpful. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. And that's the point. Is food dominating your lifestyle? Because that, the Bible says food. There's a lot of food there today. The food it is, the sin. The food it is, the touch. There's a different kind of levels of food today that you are desiring, that you honor to desire. And I don't want you, my dear friend, to be dominated by these things. The Bible says food for the stomach and stomach for the food. Now watch it. God will destroy both one and the other. So don't let food dominate your lifestyle, just as it dominated the life of Eve. And again, there's nothing wrong with feeding your body, but there's something wrong when you've been dominated by food. And so there's something wrong, my dear friend, with submitting our natural desires. But friend, there's a plenty wrong today. If that's strange your soul, my friend, the plenty wrong here today is also is very important that Jesus Christ asks this final question. What good would be for someone to gain the whole world and yet forfeit his soul? Or what can you give in exchange for your soul? Absolutely nothing, my dear friend. So seriously, I'm talking to you today. There's a lot of problems here today with the mothers here in UK. Like the Eve, she ruined her life. Do you know why? Because she fixed her eyes on the traitor that I just mentioned to you. Something good to eat, something good to look after, and something to make someone wise. Those are the three things that destroy humanity. So I want you to see here today, is your family ever dwelling in that kind of paradise? I want you to think, have you set your priority in the wrong places? And so I want you to not to care so much about the earthly things. These earthly things will destroy your soul. And so the Bible said that if she put all her emphasis is one thing, something good to eat, and something to satisfy her craving, and because her desires are the flesh. If you only care for your body and you neglect your soul, you have a problem. So you see, it doesn't matter what you have. What will not make any difference in your life is where you set your values. What really matters in this life is where your hope, where your heart is. Just Christ says, where your heart is, that's where your mind and your body and your soul will be too. So friend, I want you to see that Eve was interested in one thing. Something good to eat. Food. Unholy like Esau, whoso is birthright for a single meal. For you know afterward, when he desired to inherit the blessing, he was rejected. And he fought it with no chance to repent, and though he sought it with tears. So you see, sin is a failure to do what is right, substituting it for what is good for the best. She was interested for the food, and not only that, the Bible also says she saw that the fruit was present in the eyes. Now watch it, to make someone wise. So you see, your eyes is the gateway to the narrow way or to the broad way. But you see, my friend, this was a rosary that she was desiring to look at. She had everything that was in the garden but just one fruit. The same way to the devil will entice you to show you something pretty, but you have your wife. And if you're looking at something that is pretty, you have your wife that's very pretty to you. But devil always provide a chance for you to look at something else. So you see, as a matter of fact, God had given to her every pretty thing to look at, but she wanted one thing. You see, friend, devil will always provide for you an alternative for something pretty to look at. She was interested, just one fruit. But what about other fruit that was around her? But she was not interested by the things of God. Ladies, I want to ask you, where is your values today? If she had her value for the taste that was present to her eyes, for rosary, something to eat, something pretty to look at, and the third thing the devil put in her soul was this, if something that will stimulate her mind. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8, for those who live according to the flesh, they set their minds on the things of flesh. Now listen to this. To set the mind on the things of flesh is dead. For the mind that is on flesh is hostile to God. And those who are in flesh, the Bible says, they cannot please God. So if needed something to stimulate her mind, like many of you today, are you watching pornography? Are you looking at the things you ought not to look? I want you today to repent and give your heart to Jesus Christ. Amen? So there's always something to make you wise. Like mothers today in UK, They are exactly doing the same thing today. The worldly value mothers and those who are spiritually ignorant, the mothers who have here today, they want to know everything, see everything, do everything, join everything, and they have joined mothers today. And they have no time to teach their children the Bible studies. They have no time for fellowship, and they have no time to worship God. And some of them today are the poor mothers we have here today in UK. They almost clubbed to death. That the members of this club or that club. When I used to work in club, I used to see mothers drop their children to nightclub. What a shame, my dear friend. You can't do that, my dear friend. In fact, the Bible says, train your children the way they should grow, and they will not depart from it. And I'm preaching to you today about family home. Family home is what we need here today in UK. Home is the first thing that God built. And devil knows that he can wreck the home, and when he wrecked the home, he wrecked the whole society today. So you see, my dear friend, I want old-fashioned mothers. But the Bible describes in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 5, I remind you of your sincere faith, a faith that doeth first in your mother's loins and in your mother's innards, and now I'm sure doeth in you as well. But you see, today's mothers, some of them today are busybodies. They are out and about, going there and going there. But if you think about the most important thing that is in their life, or what they want here is their stomach, their eyes, and their mind. But I tell you one thing, my dear friend. You have a soul, and God has given you a precious children, and God has given you a family. But if you fail, if you set your mind in the wrong values, like so many mothers today, and it's a sad thing also to know that a father who have no backbone, no spine, no spine. Again, listen to what the Bible says, Genesis chapter 3 verse 6. So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that was delight to the eyes, and that was the tree that was desired to make one wise, she took the fruit of it and ate. Now watch it, she also gave it to her husband. So who was with her and he ate. So now God made Eve to be a helpmate for Adam, not an eatmate. But I want you to see, he ended up being an eatmate. And she ate the fruit, and she brought some and to give to Adam, and he ate also. That's where the whole problem started, my dear friend. That's where the failure of the family, the first family that I'm preaching to you today. Rather than Adam leading Eve, Eve was leading Adam. And Adam was much to blame in this as much as Eve was. But you see, Adam should have led the family, but he left the rightful place. You see, God made man first, and then woman second. So God planned for man is to be the head of the home. My dear friends, are you listening? God planned for man to be the head of the home, not the woman to be the head of the home. Like so many men today, so many women who are out of the place in the society. Because of this reason, because why? They refuse to follow what God have called us to do in this earth. So this reason today, there are so much problem today in our homes. And all this saying, I wish we could go back to the injection by the Bible, where God put man first. It's your duty as a mother, as a father and a mother to look after your family. It is your duty as a father to be in your rightful place. Mister, I want to tell you that your home, God is ordained you to be three things. Number one, that you be the provider. The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8 says, but if anyone does not provide for a relative, especially for the members of his own home, he has denied his the faith. Now watch it, and he's even worse than an unbeliever. So not only that you to be a provider, but God also wants you as a father to be a protector. Peter says this in 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 7. In the same way, your husband must give honor to your wife and treat your wife with understanding. As you live together, that she may be the weaker than you, but she also equal partner in God's sight of a new life, of a new life. So treat her the way you should, or your prayers will be hindered. If you're treating your wife bad, the Bible says your prayers will be hindered. Are you listening, mister? The word of God speaking to you today. And so you as a pastor in your own home, you as a father, you are a pastor in your own home. And I want you to understand this, my dear friend, because this is very important. Because many of us today, we cannot leave our responsibilities that God given to us as fathers, and we are chasing paper, and we are chasing all these things, and we have moved away. for what God actually wants us to do and how God wants us to be. When the word of God is speaking to you today, the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4, fathers, not mothers, fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in a discipline and instruction of the Lord. And any father who leaves it up to his wife to teach his children to pray, leaves it up to his wife to bring the children to church, leaves it up to his wife and to say the grace even at the table, leaves up to the wife to have Bible studies, leaves up to the wife to lead the children to Christ, he is a shrinker, he is a stalker. He's not the kind of father that the Bible teaches us to be. Where is the fathers of the old, like Joshua, who say, as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord? And the Bible teaches that you as a father, you are the head of the home. The book of Ephesians says, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. Way back in Genesis chapter 3 verse 16, God said to the woman, your desire is to be for your husband, and he will rule over you. And so, we need to go back to the basis, where the husband is the head of the house. But the problem we see in Genesis chapter 3, the first family, their fear was the mother had wrong set of values and the father did not have enough spine, no backbone to stand up and to say, as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. So you see, and I want you to see today, my dear friend, the word husband means a band of house. The husband, or the one that holds the whole family together. Mister, don't you know that you have to present, you represent God in your own home? How did Jesus Christ teach us how to pray? He taught us to pray this way, our Father, our Father. So God is a father, and I want my little son to see me like his dad, just as God like a father. God is like a father. God is a father. And we call him Abba Father, means Daddy Father. It's a sobering thought, my dear friend. Mister, don't you know in your home, you have to represent Christ? For the Bible says, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And that's what the Bible says. And that's what the Bible says. So I hope today we can go back to the basics and to understand what the Bible is telling us today. Many of us today, we have different mindset concerning what God says. But it's so clear, my dear friend, to the word of God. Some of us today will think that women ought not to curse. We have different idea today that women not to drink. We have different idea today, woman not to smoke. But man have the right to do this, all this evil thing. No, my dear friend, we got it backwards. Friend, that's not the word of God. A man ought to be just as pure, just as clean, just as gentle, just as pure, just as a chaste, as a woman who is alive here today. There's no double standards with God. God is the great equalizer. I repeat, God is the great equalizer. It takes much as the blood of Jesus Christ to save a man and the same way to save a woman. If something wrong for a woman to commit adultery, it's all wrong for a man to commit adultery. It is wrong for a woman to curse, it is also wrong for a man to curse. And if any man has one standard for his wife, another standard for himself, if any man has another standard for his children, another standard for himself, he's just a hypocrite. That's right, he's a hypocrite. So you are to represent God in your household, you as a man. And there's the three things that God has laid out for you. You are to be the provider, number one. You are to be the protector, number two. And you are to be the pastor, God bless you, sir, number three. So you are the one that God sees as a family. You, my dear friend, you are the head of the home, not the wife. That's what the Bible is telling us today. And when we get the woman head of the house, we got everything messed up. That's why the situation where we are now today in the society. Man is the head of the family. Don't get it twisted, my dear friend. And then you see Adam tried to alibi himself. He tried to put blame on Eve. He even tried to blame God. That's why he said, yes, I know that I did something wrong, but it was the woman that you gave me. She was the one. But friend, I want you, mister, to take your responsibility today so serious. We need to go back to the old-fashioned Christianity home. Amen. But the starting here is this. Not only was the mother had a set wrong of values, but the father have no backbone. And then the children left to chance and the wrong wife. And you'll find out soon. Because you see, in this year of Adam and Eve, there was a two children born, Cain and Abel, and let him that was others also, but Caleb Abel, hold truth about what you have here today. Cain grow up to be a wicked man. Abel grow up to be a good man. And now what was this? What did this happen to the one of the son becoming good and one becoming bad? The student was simply let out to the chance to do what they want to do. Men of you today, the word of God is speaking to your heart today, my dear friend. One turned out to be good, another one turned out to be bad. So you see, Adam and Eve, they were not all that bad because Adam and Eve loved God. And obviously they repented for their sin. Why? Because God clothed them with the skins of animal, which represent the shed blood of our Lord Jesus Christ and covering of the righteousness. But they were not all that good either, because Adam and Eve, like many modern Christian homes today, they were on and off again, sinning and repenting. But they have one set of values, and they have no spine backbone, and their children just went wild. Cain became a murderer. Abel loved the Lord, and he died for his faith. Madam, let me ask you a question. Do you have a wrong set of values? You see? What about you, sir? Do you have any backbone? Are you just lazy to stand up and to say, for me and my household, we will serve the Lord? And that's one of the worst things that we see today in this first family, how they fail. Because they fail, all the society fail. So it's very important we understand each home has to be built in a Christian home. If you don't have a Christian home, may I say to you today, you have a dysfunctional family. The Lord said to Cain, where is Abel your brother? He said, I don't know. Now we'll listen to this sad reply. Am I my brother's keeper? Right now in UK, we have crime, you have knife crime, you have dog roar, you have road rage. And when you ask all these people, they will tell you the same thing. Am I my brother's keeper? We are so sick in this nation today. Because why? We don't have God in our home. And when we don't have Christ in our home, my dear friend, you have a crisis in your home. So we have to see where this started. Way back in the Garden of Eden, that's where everything started. Yeah, there was a mother who had a wrong set of values. And that was a father who had no backbone. And the children were born into this family. And one of them said, after his mother, his own brother, am I my brother's keeper? May God have mercy upon UK. May God have mercy upon this society we are living today. If any mother who does not understand this thing I'm preaching to you today, who have more important thing in their life to say, something to eat, something to see, and something to think about, may God have mercy upon this society today. What about the fathers? Fathers, you ought to plant your feet firm on the rock of ages and to say, and for me and for my household, we will serve the Lord. You as a father, the Bible says you are the head of the family. Even as Christ is the head of the church. Our children have been thrown to the wolves today. Because why? The mothers have wrong set of values and the father have no backbone to stand up. And that's why today they leave the children to be chance. That's why today they go to prison. The full of young people who have no set of values because the parents did not set it for them. I pray today that we give God chance again to amend our home. Remain blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Jesus Christ is Lord.